Hello students, students of class 9th, I welcome you all again in today's session. Students, today we are going to continue our chapter, proceed further our chapter entitled as The Little Girl. In yesterday's session, we could study due to answer many casual day, the grandmother and mother of KGF were sent to a hospital and she had to remain alone in the home with Elise. And now we are going to proceed further. One request is also, you all open your book and join with me. Paragraph number 10. What will I do if I have a nightmare? She asked. Kedia asks Elise that what I will do when I will get a nightmare. You know, nightmare means a dream that makes you frightened. It means a bad omen, best dreams. Kejia is accustomed of having bad dreams, dreadful dreams. So she is asking to Elise what I will do. It means I need my granny, I need my grandmother. I often have nightmares and then grandmother takes me into her bed. I can't stay in the dark. It all get whispery. She is pleading to Elise that, you know, daily, in a general case, daily I come in my when it comes the night, I often get nightmares, bad and dreadful dreams. And when I get frightened of, when I became afraid of, I generally sleep into the bed of my grandmother and there I take my sleep. But you know, as soon as it is growing, fainting, the night, it seems to me that it is soundy. Some people is saying in a very low sound, whispery. You just go to sleep, child, said Elise, pulling off her socks. Means taking her off socks. So Elise said, you should sleep now. You know that Elise is a servant and a servant does his work, has no cares. And don't you scream and wake your poor pa. And make a notice to Kejia, when you get fearful from any nightmare, as you are saying, always remember, keep in your mind that your poor pa is there. Why this poor word is given here? Students, as I have been mentioning again and again, every word has a different meaning in different context. Here poor means a tired person. Pitiable person, not a tired person, not that he is out of economy, that he has done the work whole day and he needs rest. In that case, he is a poor person. So you should not disturb him. But the same old nightmare came. Same old. The butcher with a knife and a rope who came nearer and nearer, smiling that dreadful smile. In the night, as Kejia was mentioning just earlier, the same nightmare came, the same bad dream, the same dreadful dream appeared in the subconscious mind of the Kejia. You know, we have many births in our previous lives. So there is no very clear-cut funda or fundamental or agenda for any dream. But it is true that dreams come. In the dream, a butcher, you know, a person who cuts and sells, especially animals, is known as butcher, with a knife and a rope, leather, who is coming towards Kejia near and near with a smile, means a dreadful smile, that smile which was making fearful to Kejia. While she could not move, and the Kejia feels that in the dream she is unable to move. The students, you must have this experience that when we are in our dream, we fail to move from one place to another. Although we try much, but we fail to move. This was the same condition for Kejia. not moved, could only stand still, crying out, "Grandma, Grandma." She woke, shivering, to see father beside her bed, a candle in his hand. As a general case, she was asking her grandmother for help. But you know that grandmother was not there. She found that her father was standing with a candle, taking in his hand. "What's the matter?" he said. "Kejia, what is the matter? Why you are screaming? Why you are calling your grandmother so loudly?" "Oh, a butcher, a knife I want, granny," he explained. She explained about the nightmare and what was in the nightmare. "A butcher, a knife and a rope, what about?" He blew out the candle, means put out the candle, bent down and caught up the child in his arms. I think according to this chapter, this is the first time when a father is taking her, his lovely daughter into his arms in the night time, carrying her along the passage to the big bedroom, and he carried his daughter, lovely daughter Kezia, to his room. A newspaper was on the bed. You know, he was the fond of taking newspapers. There was a newspaper on the bed. He put away the paper, then carefully tucked up the child. He made the newspaper to one side and made Kezia to sleep very carefully and covered her with any bed sheet or any other coverings very carefully. It means in doing these activities, Kejia's father behaved as a father, not as a ruler. As a father. Father is the embodiment of care and responsibility. Both, there must be a combination of responsibility and care in father. And now he is behaving like a father. He lay down beside her and slept beside Kejia, half asleep still. Now Kejia is not in a sound sleep, he is half asleep. In some context he is sleeping from physical angle, in some context he is awakening from mental angle, half asleep. With the butcher's smile all about her, it seemed she can feel that the situation is same. A butcher is standing before her subconscious mind. She crept close to him. She moved slowly towards the body of her father. He snuggled her head under his arm. When you try to come under anyone other's personality, any other person's body, and feels that you are care, you are secure in that condition, you can use the word snuggled. Held tightly to his shirt, and you can understand the word. He took the shirt tightly. It means till this moment, Kejia has no so confident in holding her hands to the body of her father. Then the dark did not matter. She lay still. She is very still, calm. And as much as there is darkness in the room, see, for her there is no matter. "Here, rub your feet against my legs and get them warm," said father. "As it is winter season, and you must have found that in winter seasons, our feet generally gets cold." He made a request type plead. "Kejia, touch your, make your feet touched with my feet to get them warm." Tired out, he slept before the little girl. As I said earlier, due to the work of daytime, his father soon slept. Kejia was asleep. A funny feeling came over her. You know, a funny feeling, a nice feeling, a different type of experience, a different type of idea towards, a different attitude towards the looking of her father came into her mind. Not poor father, not so big after all. After all, poor father, not so big. And with no one to look after him. He was harder than grandmother, but it was a nice hardness. She realized, Kejia here realizes that although my father is hard in behavior in compared to my grandmother, but this type of hardness is not a real rude behavior. This is a sweet hardness, a care type hardness, security type hardness. All day my father lives in his factory or in his office and does a lot of work. This lot of work makes him tired. That's why he is unable to cope with me always. But he has love for me also. But it was a nice hardness. And every day he had to work and was too tired to be a Mr. McDonald. It means in compared to Mr. McDonald, McDonald has less work. My father has a lot of work. That's why he can't give as much as time as Mr. McDonald gives to his children. This is the main reason. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. She is remembering, or you can say she is recalling, in the words of Wordsworth, tranquility, recollected in tranquility. She is remembering, she is recalling the incident of tearing the fine papers to put to fill into the pin cushion, that those were very important for my father and I tore them all. When a person, students, realizes that I was wrong, for the other person simultaneously arises a sense of respect. When you consider you were wrong and then he was right, automatically an inner conscience gives respect, a sense of respect, and that is coming into the heart of KGF. She stayed suddenly in sight. She moved, turned immediately and made a yell. "What's the matter?" asked the father. "Another dream." "KGR, do you have another dream? What is the matter? Are you in trouble? Do you have any problem, Betty?" Like this, he is saying. You know, in our words, we call Betty a very good tone. "Do you have any problem, daughter?" "Betty?" "Oh," said the little girl, "my head is on your heart." What's he saying? "My head in the sleeping position." You can understand the head of KGI is under the arms of her father. "I can hear it going. What a big heart you have got, father dear." See, perhaps he is saying mentally. Now this is the metamorphically. You see, can hear what is going on in the heart. Means she is in the mood of saying that, readers, now I can understand how merciful, how careful, how sincere, how caring natured person my father is towards me. It was a situation then she was thinking that why creator has made fathers, and now she is thankful. She must have been very thankful to the God that you have made fathers. Student, this is the time that is the best teacher of the world. So at present, if you feel that this is not good for me, so don't be sure. In coming time, you can think this can also be beneficial for you. By this way, we conclude our chapter. As you know, in exercise, there is one question, question number 3. How does Kejia begin to see her father as a human being who needs her sympathy? Who needs her sympathy? You know, during the night time, when Kejia's father came to her room with the candle and took her into his room and made and gave her a good sleep, secured sleep, then it struck into the mind of Kejia that I should also pay my sympathy, my love, my care, not care, my love, my respect to my father also. So you should try to write the answer of this question. Where till we talk about thinking about language, you can see the video number 1 of this chapter, there I had attempted. And if you have any problem in exercise and the writing, the solving of exercise, you can comment in the comment sections. This way we complete our lesson 3. The Little Girl, written by Catherine Mansfield. I hope you all have enjoyed this lesson and you must have completed your notebook writing. What should be the order of completing a notebook? I would like to remember you once, recall you once. First, you should write word meaning. Then you should write thinking about the text. And after then, if you get up, you are likely to move further, you should go thinking about the language. This should be the order of writing on notebooks. On notebooks, you write clearly, revise clearly, and if there is any problem, you should make a call also. You should comment in the comment box, and when we join our class through Jesty app or Google Meet app, you can discuss about it also. At last, I wish you all remain safe and healthy in your homes with your family members, and enjoy your study. Thanks.